Hello friends, welcome to the Tech Grinth. Today we will solve lead code problem called course schedule, and the problem statement says that there are a total of num courses which you have to take, and those courses are leveled from 0 to num courses minus 1, and this has been given to us as an input, and that input is like an integer. So if an integer like 2 or 3 has been passed here, it means that I have 3 courses which I have to complete. Next that is given to us is a 2D array which denotes that there are some prerequisite for the course. For example, if we take this prerequisite, it means that before completing course 1, I have to complete course 0. So this can be something like this, where I have an array of an array, and here we have 1 0, then we have 2 1, then we can have like 3 1, then I can have another thing like 3 2. So what this means is that before completing course 1, I have to complete course 0. Before completing course 2, I have to complete course 1. Before completing course 3, I have to complete course 1. And before completing course 3, I have to complete course 2 also. So 3 is dependent on both 1 and 2. 2 is dependent on just 1. And 1 is dependent on 0. So this is the prerequisite that has been given to us. Now, given the total number of course that I have to complete and given a prerequisite, we have to tell that whether it is possible to complete all the courses or not. So if we have a scenario like this, the example 2 here, where course 1 is dependent on course 0. So before completing course 1, I have to complete course 0. And before completing course 0, I have to complete course 1. So it is like a cycle here. So I cannot complete either of these two courses. So in this case, I have to return false because I won't be able to complete the courses, all the courses that has been given to me. So if you look at the constraint from here, we can understand that this is like a graph kind of problem. So if we take this example, so we can think like we have a node here, which is node of value 0. Then from 0, I have something like this. So this is course 1. Now, this means that before completing course 1, I have to complete course 0. Okay. And similarly, we can have from course 1, I have a dependency of course 3 and course 2. So here, if I see, I have a dependency here. So before completing course 2, I have to complete course 3 here. And before completing course 2, I have to complete course 1 here. And here is one more. So this is course 3. So before completing course 3, I have to complete course 1, and I also have to complete course 2. So this is how this graph will come out. So how we can read this graph is, so I have course 0, 1, 2, and 3. Course 0, there is no dependency. We can complete it anytime, or we can start it anytime we want. Course 1, to start course 1, I have to complete course 0. So course 0 has to be completed, and then only course 1 can start. For course 2, course 1 should be finished. Once course 1 is done, then only I can complete course 2. For course 3, both course 1 and course 2 should be finished. So this is how we will read this particular graph. Now the question is how we can solve this particular problem. So we will convert this graph into an adjacency list, and in Java for adjacency list we can basically use a map, and that map can look something like a map of integer. So these courses are all integer, so we can have a map something like this, where we have a map of integer, and then we have a list here, list of integer. Okay, so this is how we can represent the adjacency list for this particular graph. If you do not have an understanding of adjacency list, please go back and read about it, because that is the core concept of graphs and how the graph can be represented in any language. So basically there are two ways, either using an adjacency list or an adjacency matrix. Those two can be used. Both have their own benefit and disadvantages also. So here we will use adjacency list, and how we will create adjacency list is, we will have a map of the courses data dependent on the other course. So we will say for course 1 to complete, so here we will put like, if I am able to complete course 0, so I can start with course 1. So the list will look something like this. Then if I am able to complete course 1, I can start with course 2 and course 3. And if I am able to complete course 2, I will go ahead and start with the course 3. And if I have completed course 3, then there is nothing to start with in this particular example. So this is how the list will look like. Now, once we have the adjacency list for this particular problem, and the way we have created the adjacency list is the way we have drawn this graph. So we will complete course 0. So once I have completed course 0, I can go and complete course 1. Next, when I have completed course 1, then I can start course 2 and I can also start course 3. Okay, so but course 3 has one more incoming arrow. This is called in degree, because these are incoming arrows. These two are out degree. These two are for 1, these two are out degree. For 3, these two are in degree. So since 3 has another dependency, that it should also wait for 2. So that is why after completing 1, 3 will not start, because it has to still wait for 2. That kind of dependency is there. So from this map, we can tell that, okay, whenever we have completed course 0, what all course we can start with. So this adjacency list tells me that once I have completed one course, what other course I can start and complete easily. Now next thing that I have to maintain, because we saw an example here that even though we completed 1, we can go and start with 3, but 3 has to wait for 2 also. So we have to maintain the in degree as well, and that in degree means that in degree can be represented as an like a list which will tell that for each of the nodes that are present, how many in degrees are present for that particular node. So for 0, if we see, so in degree for 0, it is 0, because for 0 I don't have any incoming node. Now same thing will go for the others. So for in degree of 1, 2 and 3, so in degree of 1 will be 1, because 1 incoming node is here, so this will be 1. For 2, still 1 incoming node is there, so in degree of 2 will be equal to 1, and in degree of 3 will be 2, because there are 2 incoming nodes here, so in degree of this will be equal to 2. So once I know the in degrees, so that way I know that even though I have completed course 1, I cannot start course 3, because the in degree of course 3 is 2. So I still need to wait for one more dependency to complete for course 3. So we'll use these two logic, and then we will use topological sort. So topological sort can be done using a queue, and that queue can be in Java, it can be an implementation of a linked list. So in that particular queue, what we will do is, in that queue we will first add all those nodes which does not have an incoming node, like what we had here for 0. So we'll add all those. Suppose there was another node here, something like a course 5. So this course 5 does not have any dependency and it could be completed easily. Or we could have another here like course 6, and 1 had a dependency here. So 1 had a dependency on course 6, something like this. So since these does not have any incoming nodes, so I can still go ahead and add these in our queue, because these can be completed first. Now if this is the case, then for 1 we have to go and increase the in degree to 2 here. Okay, so the problem now boils down to, and the next thing is, when we are doing topological sort, so that time once we have completed all these courses, then we can basically reduce the in degree for the incoming node of 1. So if I have completed 0, I have completed 5 and I have completed 6, I can reduce the in degree of 1. That way I can start 1. So when I reduce the in degree of 1, as and when I have completed the prerequisite for 1. So if I have completed 0, because 0 did not have any incoming node or any incoming edge, so when I have completed 0, so I can reduce the in degree of 1 by a factor of 1, because one of its dependency is completed. Similarly, when I complete course 1, I can reduce the incoming degree or int degree of 2 and 3 by 1 because one of its dependency is completed. And that is how we will go about this particular problem. So what all things we need to take care in this particular problem is, first we need to create an adjacency list for the problem that we have, or for the prerequisite to the course that we built here. So a list like this, we will create a map and we'll populate it. So that adjacency list will be created. The second thing that we will do here is that we will create the int degree, or we'll populate the int degree list that we have, which will tell us what are the number of incoming edges for each of the nodes. And once this is done, then we will use our queue to sort and process. So let us look into the solution, and maybe it will be more clear. If you have any doubt, just go back in the video and look for the explanation. Still you have some issue, then put it in the comment section and I will definitely answer that. So we will have a map here. Map will be of integer, and it will be of list of integer. So this we can say map is equals to new hash map, and we'll have an int degree. We'll have, this will be like an integer, so it will be list of this will be list of integer, and this will be equal to new int, and this will be equal to num courses. So whatever is the number of courses, so that many in degree or that many nodes will be there for which we have to compute the number of incoming edges. So once we have these two, we also need a queue, but we'll deal with it later. First let us populate the map. So for populating the map, what we need to do is we need to go through the prerequisite. So whatever prerequisite that we have, so we'll say whatever integer of prereq. So this prerequisite will have two elements. So 0th element will tell that the dependent element, and the first will tell that what is the element on which the first one is dependent. So the second one will tell what is the course to be taken, and this course to be taken will be equal to this prereq of 1. And the first one will take that course, or let us make it as course, and this will be dependent. So this dependent will be equal to prereq of 0. So dependent means this is dependent on my course. So once course completes, then only this dependent can be completed. So what we can do here is that we will say that list of integer dependent list is equals to map dot get for the course, and if this dependent list is equals to null, so in that case we will initialize the dependent list. So we'll say that dependent list is equals to new array list, something like this, and then we can say that dependent list dot add, and we'll add the dependent. So we'll add the dependent here. Okay, so I hope this makes sense. Now next thing is that when we have added the dependency, so this particular list will be populated here. Whatever whatever list that we were looking for, or whatever adjacency list that we were looking for, it will get populated. Next thing is that we also need to populate the int degree. So for the int degree array, we will say that in degree of whenever we get the dependent or the dependent course here. So whenever we encounter this, you increment it by 1. What this means is that so for the first time when the course came and that course was course 1, it means that course 1 is dependent on one of the courses, so it has one incoming edge. So I will increment the in degree where position of 1. So in degree array will initially be like position of in degree will be 0, 1, 2, 3 like that, and the value of all these will be 0, 0, 0, 0. So when I encountered first time that there is a dependency on node 1, I will increment it by 1. Next time when I encountered this, so I will increment the 2 by 1. So this will be 1. For 3, since there is a dependency on 1, I will increment it by 1. Again, I encountered for 3, there is a dependency on 2, I will increment it by 2. So this means that 3 has 2 incoming node, 2 has 1 incoming node, 2 has 1 incoming node, 1 has 1 incoming node, and 0 has 0 incoming node, which will be something like this, the previous diagram that we had here, this initial one. So this is how this in degree will be defined for us. Okay, I hope this part is pretty clear. So till here we are ready with our map, the adjacency list, and also with our in degree. So once we are done with these two, next we need to have a queue to sort our list and also to see how many courses are complete. So this will be list of integer, and this can be an implementation of linked list in Java, and we need to have a counter. So this will tell that how many courses that we have completed. Okay, and another thing that we can do is we can just go with we can basically go through our in degree list. So this will be I less than in degree dot length, which is same as the number of courses that we have. So I hope this one is stupidity. So, and this will be I plus plus. So, and here we will see that if the in degree of I is equals to 0, it means that it does not have any incoming edges. So we can add this in our queue straight away. So these can be processed first and it can be completed. Basically, we can take these courses without having any dependency, so we can add it in our queue. So we'll add I in our queue since these have in degree of 0. Now once these are done, we can go through our queue till it is not empty. So we'll go through the queue and we'll say int value is equals to queue of pole, and we'll increment our counter. So it means that there is something in our queue and we have basically polled it, and it means that we have completed that course, we have processed that course. Now since we have completed that course, so in this case 0, or if we look at the map, so in our map we have completed the course 0. So all the courses that are there as part of that list which are dependent on 1, so we can decrement there. In degree, because one of the dependency of that particular course is completed. So we can basically just scroll through that particular list that is there as part of the value map, and we can decrement the values. So we can say int dependency, and this will be coming from map dot get. The key will be this value, because it will be the list of values that are dependent on this particular value. So for all these value, we can just decrement the in degree. So this in degree of these will be minus minus, and here we can put a check that if in degree of this dependency has become 0 after completing this course, it means that all its dependency have been completed. So since all the dependency has been completed, these can be offered into the queue. These can be basically added in the queue. So I will add this particular I will add this particular dependency in the queue. It means that all its dependency are already completed, so that's why it's in degree 0 now, and we can process this particular course now, or we can basically take this course now. And that is it for this while loop. So as and when we come out of this loop, when the queue is empty, our counter will keep on increasing, and in the end we can simply say count is equal to the number of courses. If these two are matching, then it means that we have completed all the courses. Otherwise, we have not completed all the courses. So let us run this. It has some null pointer exception, and that null pointer exception is because this dot size is equal to 0, then we'll add it. It still says that it's a null pointer exception. Null pointer exception means, so this list has not been initialized anytime. We can get error like this in general for when we are creating adjacency list. It's okay that it came up. So a simple solution in this particular case is that we can add a for loop here, and we can basically go through all the courses and the dependency that we have for each of the courses basically, and this will be int I is equals to 0, I less than the num courses I plus plus, and here I can do map dot I can just say map dot put the course, and I can create a new array list here. So this should solve the problem. Oops. I'm not going to make this video again. I'm sorry for all these trouble. So yeah, the logic was pretty okay. Only problem was with the course that we had. So this is true. Let us submit this. So it is accepted. So that is how we will basically approach any graph problem where we have a dependency like this. If you go to lead code, there is another problem similar to this where we have course schedule 2. So even this problem is similar to the last one, but in this case it is expecting the integer output, which means that we want to give the list of courses that we have taken. So in this case it has some dependency and all, and we need to give the list the order in which we are taking the courses. So like for this example, if you see, we had to first take course 0, then course 2, then course 1, and then course 3. So this will be similar to what we have solved here. The only difference will be that rather than whenever we are adding something in our queue, so that time we can just add it in our that integer array which we have to return. We will add it in that also. So as and when we are adding something in our queue, it means that we can take those courses basically. So that is how you will solve the problem. So that's it for this video. See you in the next one. Do like and share and subscribe to the channel. Take care. Bye.